Hi all, in this video lecturer I am going to explain you about an operation of timer A in the sampling mode. Before getting into this operation of timer A in a sampling mode, I hope everyone are aware of a timer A operation regarding a timer block and a capture compare block. With that assumption, I will get into this actual topic. Okay, this is a really a particular application of a compare mode. Okay, if you are operating in a sampling mode, means the main purpose we are serving here is comparing the bits. This is something like a sample and hold circuit, but it is purely for digital rather than analog signal, where we actually do a sample and hold. Okay, during an analog to digital conversion, we are going to do the sampling and then hold thing. It is used when digital input needs to be sampled at preset times and main application is to asynchronous serial communication. Okay, you may wonder why I want to operate a timer A in a sampling mode. Okay, I think you will get it clear if I take this example. Okay, this is an asynchronous serial communication protocol. Okay, here you can see there is in some ideal state. And here it has been showing that start bit, then there is within some values, then here it has a stop bit. Okay, this is the protocol it is going to be following in asynchronous serial communication. If there is no transmission, it will be in an idle state. Okay, it is in an high state. Okay, when you are going to call it as a start, there it will be pushing the communication channel from an high state to a low state. Okay, that means I can tell that whenever there is a falling transition from an ideal state, then I can detect that as a start bit. Okay, you will be knowing that what is the amount of time it will be pulling for the start bit. Okay, if I check it on the middle point of that, if it is zero, then I can come to the conclusion that it is a start bit. Then it is going to transfer the data. Okay, here it has been transferred 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 0. Okay, that is nothing but it has been transferred an 8 bit of information. After the completion of a byte transfer, it has been pulling back to an high state. Okay, that means after a 8 bit of transition, if my next bit is in an high state, then I can tell that 1 byte of transmission has been occurred. Fine. Okay, suppose if you get in any scenario, there may be a chances of transmitting in multiple bytes. At that time, starting stage is similar. Okay, it is going to fall it. Once you have gotten 0 bit here, we think that it is in starting. Then an 8 bit of information will be transferred. Then it is going to send and stop bit. Then once again, it pulls down to low, 0 start bit. It is going to transfer and bit. Then it is going to send a stop bit. Okay, if you want to do a multiple transmission, always you need to have a start bit and then stop bit. Okay, that means total how many bit of transmission it is going to happen? 8 bits for an byte data and 1 bit for a start bit, another 1 bit for a stop bit. That means total 10 bits have been required for an asynchronous communication. Okay, as you all know that asynchronous means you don't know that at what time it is going to be starting. Okay, that is the one thing. Okay, if it is synchronous, you know the time at what time you have been transferring so that you can synchronize your clock with that particular time. But in an asynchronous, I need to detect where it has been actually having and falling it. Okay, now let us try to relate this to our timer A. By using any of the things, can we identify this falling edge? Of course, yes. In a capture compare channel, we have a detection for a falling edge transition. Okay, if I put my timer in a capture mode, then if I have been waiting to be detecting a falling edge, once it has been detected, I can make sure that interrupt has been generated. Then after some middle period of year, I am going to check that value, input value, whether it is exactly equal to 0. Okay, if it is exactly equal to 0, I can tell that it is a start bit. Otherwise, due to a noise, it might have gone to a low. Okay, I need to discard it. Okay, if it is not 0, then I will put back 2 into n once again into n capture on falling edge mode. But if there is a 0 here, then I will make sure that what the time period I will be known that I am going to compare the event after in some certain number of period. I am going to capture the value. I hope everyone are clear. I think if you see this diagram, I think you will be getting a better understanding. Okay, during in first I will put our timer A in and capture mode for a falling edge. Okay, once it has been detected and falling edge in a compare mode, then I am going to set my timer A in a compare mode. Okay, in a compare mode we are going to specify the timer count bit rate. Okay, what is that count we are going to give? Okay, that count it need to be half the bit length. Okay, you will be knowing that what is the bit length it is going to be transferred. Okay, I'm going to set half of the bit length in the middle in order to know what is the status of that value. In an interrupt service routine, in a compare mode, once it has been reached that particular point, it is going to generate an interrupt. There I am going to check the input value. If it is exactly equal to 0, then it has been starting of an asynchronous communication. If it is not 0, then I will push back my system once again into a capture mode. Okay, I hope everyone are clear with the start condition. Okay, if there is a successful of a start bit, what is the next thing I want to do? In the next thing what I want to do is, for further next 8 bits, I need to store the information. Okay, here I need to specify what is the next count or what is the next compare point it need to capture the input signal and it need to be stored. Okay, here I need to take the exact bit length here from this point to this point. Exactly on the middle we are going to check what is the input value. If I am going to compare here means I am going to increment the TACCR 0 value or any of the channel value. I am going to add it. Then I am going to take this value. Then once it has been taken, once again in that interrupt service routine, we are going to increment the TACCR with a bit length value. Like this, we are going to continuously read all the 8 bits of an information. After the 8 bit of an information, we are going to check for another time period bit length. It need to be exactly equal to 1. That tells that full transmission has been occurred. Otherwise, if it has a value rather than a 1, we will think that there is some miscalculation or some mischievous things have been occurred and we are going to discard that entire byte. Fine. Okay, I forgot to tell you about this communication protocol. Okay, while sending the byte information, which bit is going to be transferred first? Okay, in this asynchronous series communication, the first bit it is going to transfer is an LSB bit. Last bit will be your MSB bit. Fine. Okay, here you may get another question. In what mode my timer A was running? Okay, whether it is an up mode or a continuous mode or up down mode. I hope in our previous video lecture I have told that if I don't know what is the time period we are going to use, we usually put our system into a continuous mode. Okay, here also in a sampling mode we are going to put our system in a continuous mode. Fine. Okay, let us try to see the what all the points it has been given in your textbook. I hope everyone are clear with this one. First, initially the system will be in a capture mode. Whenever there is a falling edge transition, it will come to the conclusion that start bit transmission has been started. Then with an off bit length, we are going to check that whether that bit value is exactly equal to 0. In order to do this one, my timer A need to be shifted into a compare mode. Okay, there if it is exactly equal to 0, we will proceed further. Otherwise, in an interrupt service routine, we will make sure that it has been once again put back into a compare mode, capture mode itself. Okay, if it has been 0, then we are going to take the bit length value to a counter register, then we are going to do in a comparing mode. Okay, that's why it is been also called as a sample and hold. Okay, we have been sampling at a regular interval. That's why it is the name it is called sampling mode. Operational steps you can say, check. Between transmission, the channel waits in a capture mode for a falling edge on its input. An interrupt is requested when edge is detected. Okay. The channel is switched to the compare mode first, and the next event is set for half the length of a bit in the time. That is nothing but half bit length is loaded. The next interrupt occurs after the compare event. Okay, that means the count has been reached, means it is going to get a compare event. It should be in the middle of the start bit, and the SCCI bit is checked to confirm this. Okay, through an SCCI bit we can know the what is the input value. Okay, if it is 0 as expected, next compare event is set up occur after further bit length. Means 0 means it has been actual transmission has started, that's why next compare event will be set for a further bit length. If SCCI is 1, the initial merge has been a noise and the channel is switched back into a capture mode to wait for the next valid transmission. Next, after the next interrupt, SCCI contains the value of the least significant bit. This is stored and the next compare event is set to occur after a further bit length. Okay, like this it is repeated until all 8 bits of data have been received. A final compare event for the stop bit. Okay, stop bit is to set to occur after further bit length. The final sample is checked to verify that SCCI is equal to 1 as expected for a stop bit. Okay, if it is 1, no problem, we are going to take a new bit as been received. If not, framing error occurred and byte is discarded. Okay, if it is 1, no problem, the main routine is alerted that new byte has been received. If not, framing error occurred and byte is discarded. What happens after this case? Okay, whether it is correct or a discarded frame. Okay, in both of the cases, we will put back our system back to a capture mode. Okay, this is all about your timer in a sampling mode. Thank you for watching.